Hello guys, so this is your next problem. Here this is again we are doing straight lines. Here it is said that a point A comma 2A is lying on y by 2 is equal to 3x minus 6, and we have to find out what is the value of A. So as it is already said that A comma 2A is lying on this line, so this two points must satisfy this equation. So what I did is we just replaced y and x by 2a and a, and we calculated the value of a. That is what is asked in this question. Okay, and we have found out what is a is equal, what is the value of a, and we found out it is as 3. Okay, so go to the next problem. This was pretty easy. Okay, so in this problem it is said that if the inclination of a line is 60 degree, okay, inclination of a line is 60 degree. So this basically means this is the x-axis and y-axis, then this is the line and this angle is 60 degree. So the theta value is 60 degree, and so the slope is m is equal to tan 60 degree, that is root 3. So slope is known to me, and it is also passing through a point 0 comma minus 3. So what I did is I use the point and slope form of the equation of straight line. So y minus y1 is equal to nx minus x1. So here x1 and y1 is given 0 comma minus 3. I have just substituted the values to get the equation of straight line. Y plus 3 is equal to root over 3x. Okay guys, this is a very nice problem. Two equations of the lines were given to us. One is y is equal to root 3x plus 1, and another is y is equal to x plus 1. So if you see y is equal to root 3x plus 1, I can easily say that the slope of this line is root 3. Okay, m is equal to root 3. From there I can find out the theta, that is 60 degree. So this one is 60 degree. And from this one I can also find out same way, m is equal to 1, so theta will be 45 degree. So that is this one 45 degree. And see, if I have to calculate this theta, the angle between two lines, I need to know the other angles of this triangle. So if I know that this is 60, this will be 120, and this is 45, so 120 and 45 will be 165. 180 minus 165 will get this theta, that is as 15 degree. Okay, it's a very nice problem. Okay, so we'll go to the next one now. So find the slope of the line. Okay, here it is said to calculate the slope of the line joining two points. Okay, so how do I do this? We have a formula, m is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. In case of two points are given, we can easily find out the slope. So here x1 and y1 values we have put from this coordinate, and x2 and y2 value from this coordinate, and then we have substituted to get the value of the slope. Okay, so I hope you understood this problem. Thank you. So we'll go to the next one now. Okay, here it is said find the intercepts made by the line. So this is very easy. If you go to this one, we have already covered this in this one, this problem. 3x plus 5y plus 7 is equal to 0. To get the x intercept, you have to put y is equal to 0. To get the y intercept, you have to put x is equal to 0. Okay, so here also the same thing is done. While we have found out the y-intercept, we have put x is equal to 0 to get the value of y-intercept, that is let us come up 4. So the coordinate is 0 comma 4, and for x-intercept we have put y is equal to 0, we have got x is equal to minus 6, so the coordinate is minus 6 comma 0. Okay, okay, go to the next one now. Here it is said ABCD, very nice problem. ABCD is a parallelogram. The coordinates of ABCD is given, only A is unknown to us because A has given us XY. I have to find out what is the coordinates of A. So see, if I have to find out the coordinates of A, I have to find some connection with the other line that I have got. So here both are diagonals. So in case of diagonals, diagonals of a parallelogram is bisecting each other. So this point, the midpoint of bisecting each other, means this point is midpoint of this BD and also AC. So if I can find out this point, it gives me some chance. So I can easily find out this point because it is midpoint of B and D. So that has come out to be 7 by 2 comma 2. Now this point is also midpoint of x comma y and here 4 comma 7. So I can easily do x plus 4 by 2, that is the midpoint one. X plus 4 by 2 is equal to 7 by 2, and we can do y plus 7 by 2 is equal to 2. By that I got the value of x and y. Okay, so here by this I can easily calculate what is coordinate of A. Now the next one is how to find out the equation of BD. Okay, so if two points are known to me, these two points, okay, then finding equation is pretty easy to us, because if two points are known, just use this formula and you will get the equation of BD. Okay, so this is our next problem, which is said that write down the equation of the line whose gradient is 3 by 2. When it is said that the gradient is 3 by 2, it becomes quite easy now, because n is equal to 3 by 2. Okay. Now I need one point, y minus y1 is equal to mx minus x1, remember? So I need another point. I know the slope, I need another point. So which is the point? P divides, this is the point, P divides A comma B, that these two coordinates are given in the ratio 2:3. So I put the coordinate of A, I put the coordinate of B, ratio is 2:3. I can easily find out the coordinate of P by section formula, and using that 0,5 and slope is known, you can easily calculate what is the equation of straight line. So I'm just giving you hints and letting you do the problems by yourself. Okay, so this is again a nice problem. Equation of the diagonals of rectangles, you have to find out whose sides are given. So see, if the first side is x is equal to minus 1, so it will be parallel to the y-axis, x is equal to minus 1, this one, and x is equal to 2, so this will be again parallel to y-axis, and then y is equal to minus 2 parallel to x-axis, y is equal to 6 parallel to y-axis. Now from this I am getting one rectangle. Okay, in this rectangle how do I point out what are the vertices? So it is very easy to find out what is the vertices of the rectangle. If you see 2 comma minus 2, it should be 2 comma minus 2. Why? Because it is the this point is intersection of x is equal to 2 and y is equal to minus 2, so it will be 2 comma minus 2. Similarly it will be 2 comma 6, try to find out minus 1 comma 6 and minus 1 comma minus 2. Here it is 2 comma 6 because it is the intersection of the y is equal to 6 line and the x is equal to 2 line, so it will be 2 comma 6. Okay, so that way I have found out all the coordinates. As soon as I can find out all the coordinates, the equation of diagonal is child's play for me right now. By this equation I'll find out the equation of diagonals. So I've covered more or less the types of problems that have been going to ask in ICC examinations. Towards you, I have not solved the all the problems for you, because I want you guys to solve this so that you gain confidence. Okay, so thank you. We'll proceed with the next part of the session in the next video.